It's Asperia Works Cinema, where we watch all the movies. Today I'm starting the Quentin Tarantino director series, trying to get at least one entry out there for each of the directors so you can see who I'm going to go through. And I'm going to start with Four Rooms. Why Four Rooms? Why not? We just watched this last night, so it seemed like a good enough place to start. I hadn't actually seen Four Rooms. I don't remember ever seeing it on release. I think the last time I saw the movie was in the theater. This doesn't have a release in the States at all. This is the German? Yeah, German release of it. It's a fine transfer. It's definitely a Blu-ray. Nothing super fancy. This is in the Tarantino series because he's producer and directs the last segment. So let's talk about the movie as a whole. It's a vignette series of film, which, you know, so you got four different chunks done by four different directors. This can work, and it's always going to have that jumping of feeling. Like, if you watch something like ABCs of Death, which is 26 directors, some are amazing, and some are complete garbage. And that's what you get with this, too. They're just longer. So they're like 30-minute segments. The first one, it's about a coven of witches. It all centers around the bellhop and the stories that he's encountering, and much like the Jerry Lewis film, which they reference later. And it works in that context, except you really feel the lacking of the stories. And I think the problem is the variance in ability of the directors. Our first one on the coven of witches is a throwaway story that makes no sense. It's just random. You want to throw in the sexuality, and to me, I feel this is because of the Lewis movie, but the one girl gets topless, and then there's a scene where two of them are topless, two of them are dressed, Madonna being one. Weird there. She likes taking her clothes off. You would have thought she would have been one of the topless ones. And then Alicia Witt takes off her shirt, and she's got tape over her boobs. So, well, you could have left them dressed, I would have been fine. Or had them all topless. Fine. Pick one. It just looks weird. And it's like they're coming to witches. Why would they care? And why would some of them care? And what was the point of take? It's like it wanted to be exploitative, but they were being exploitative with restrictions, so it comes off as just silly. But the whole problem with the story was it just doesn't work. It's not interesting. The dialogue is awful. The character interactions are pointless. Madonna's acting in it. What more do you want? The whole thing was she was supposed to get a dude's semen, and she decided to swallow that day instead of keep it in a cup, so she has to have sex with the bellboy to get it, and then they raise some chick out of the pool. That's it. I don't know. It's awful. It was near that 30 minutes, it felt way too long. There was no story there to hold a 30 minute. It was like an idea that was never filled. The second one, much better than that. It's, again, a bit shallow on the directing side. It comes off as very generic. I would rate this along a quality of a B-grade Tales from the Crypt episode, you know? The guy, Bill Hop, storms in, and the lady's like, and the man is there holding a gun on his wife, and then he accuses the bellboy of sleeping with her, and the drama ensues. The main problem with this is it doesn't really go anywhere, and we don't quite get it. They're apparently joking. And I watched this last night, and that's all I can remember about that segment. So that should say a lot about it. It was definitely more interesting than the first one, but not very good either. Now, both that director and the director of the first one, I had to go look up on IMDb to see, who are these clowns? What have they done? Oddly, they hadn't done anything I've heard of before Four Rooms, so they must have just been friends of Quentin's and got put in there, and they've never gone on to do anything of note or merit, so very strange inclusion for those two. I would have much rather seen any director that had more of an artistic style to conflict. So then we get to Robert Rodriguez's segment, who will have his own director series. Absolutely love Rodriguez on every aspect. I just haven't figured out where I'm going to start for his series yet. He does my most despised type of film, kids' films. They're usually dumb. Again, Rodriguez being the exception here. And he shows that very much in Four Rooms. This was pre-Spy Kids. And this showed what he could do. He takes a concept I don't care about. Two kids being brats that need to be babysat. Terrible idea. Yet, I was interested. He made it over the top, exciting, thrilling. Even the kids' acting and reactions are actually good. It's a standout piece of the film. I actually think it's better than Quentin's overall. It was exciting. I was engaged the entire time through it. You got ridiculousness happening throughout, especially at the end. Poor Tim Roth being abused beyond words. Fantastic. Banderas, who I wish to God that man got more work in the U.S. because he deserves it. He's a fantastic and charismatic actor. Absolutely my favorite of the four. I'm going to get to Tarantino's, which is I want to call it a send-off to the Hitchcock episode, which they're kind of trying to reenact. It was interesting because most of the, I think the whole thing is only done in a couple of takes with that main chunk in the beginning all in one take. The main problem I have there is it's mostly Quentin acting. Quentin's fine as a cameo. He really is. And his dialogue is really good. But him delivering it, not so much. It comes off, it really slows back down after Rodriguez's. Rodriguez's episode was so high energy and intense that this kind of slows it down. The payoff is there, I think. It just takes so long getting to it, and some of the dialogue falls flat that by the time you get to the payoff with Roth, it's okay. And then you have the end of it. I think it's, definitely the weakest of anything Tarantino's done, even a Death Proof or... I don't know how to explain this one. I get why it hasn't been released, because it probably won't sell that well. I think it's very important to watch it, because it shows some interesting flashes, especially, this is the genesis of Rodriguez's career into making kids' films, which gave him tons of money so he could get nonsense like Machete, which is awesome. I'm glad he has the financing to independently produce stuff like that after the success of children's movies, and his children's movies are fantastic. They're interesting movies. I can watch them with a kid or with myself and not want to hang myself, which is the problem with most kids' movies. So, everyone's is interesting. This is our first entry on Tarantino. I have a lot to talk about with his various films and some quirks that he has, with casting mainly is my issue usually with Tarantino. But, so there you go. Let me know your favorite Tarantino movie, and we'll see you here next time on Movie Mayhem.